الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين الابتلاء سنة من سنن الله تبارك وتعالى في هذا الكون ومع عباده testing people with different calamity and hardship is one of the decreed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regardless if they are good or bad. Calamity, when it comes for those who are good and those who are bad, those who are believers and those who are disbelievers. When the calamity falls on the Muslims, it is for that Allah, rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy from Allah. And the disaster when it falls on the disbelievers, to be a hardship for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wa lanabluwannakum بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. Indeed, we shall test you. So don't think because you are Muslim, because you come to the mosque, because you go to make Hajj, because you give in a sadaqah, doing all these things, that everything is going to be nice and pleasant for you. You are not better than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we understand he got sick. He got poisoned. كسرت رباعيته وشق وجهه sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He been hurt in the battlefield. It's not because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did something wrong, but this is a test, is a bala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed to be happening to everything and to everybody. The believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate him. And if he has some sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes some of his sins with this calamity, sickness, illness, poverty, hardship, difficulty. And for the disbelievers, this is because what their hands had achieved. So we shouldn't be scared from the qada of Allah. And we shouldn't be upset when the hardship passed by us. And it is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. He doesn't put the whole bala on us, but he gave us a little touch from testing. He said, we shall test you with some of, not the whole thing. What was supposed to be our attitude and reaction when hardship falling on us? Return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, try to improve our condition, try to cleanse our hearts. And when we see any hardship that the people going through it, regardless of Muslims or non-Muslims, we have to search in our own self. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فكفرت بأنعم الله فأذاقها الله لباس الجوع والخوف بما كانوا يصنعون. Allah gave a parable, Allah gave example with a town that was safe and secure, and the favor of Allah was coming to it, to this town, from everywhere. But they disbelieve, they've been disobedience, they're doing the haram. So Allah say, فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ. And He said, أَذَاقَهَا is only a test. Because we could not bear Allah's punishment. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He gave us illness or sickness or earthquake, it doesn't take everybody. Because it's a touch. He punish you, He test you, and His mercy is still there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بشيء, some, and the sum is little from the all. And here Allah said, فَأَذَاقَهَا, make them taste, only a taste. There is a difference between tasting a food and eating the whole meal. If Allah dropped on us the illness, the sickness, the poverty, drop it on us, as when the rain come, we're going to be finished. But Allah test us and give us a taste. So Allah telling us in the Quran, to reflect on this example, this town used to be safe and secure. And without safety, doesn't matter where you live, what kind of food you're eating. Without safety and security, without fear, if there is a fear, and you have the best wife, and you have the best house, and you have the best of everything, you could not even sleep. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them everything. The amn and security is very important. And in addition to this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَأْتِهَا رِزْقُهَا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. Its provision comes from everywhere. Everywhere. The food coming all the way to them. They don't have even to go and get it. But what happened? فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. They disbelieve in Allah's favor. They reject. So it's because what is the people, بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. It's because what your hand achieved. And Allah forgive many, many, many. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with people according to their deed, مَا تَرَكَ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ. Allah is not going to leave even any moving creature upon the surface of the earth. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. Disbelieving in Allah in a different form. Not to be grateful or being in partnership beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? فَأَذَاقَهَا لِبَاسِ. What is libas? The dress, the clothes, the soap that you wear. Because this is the closest thing to your body. So now, also, the libas is supposed to be covering you. So when Allah dropped on them, He dropped something enough for them. And He said libas. So as if they are wearing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent on them in the punishment, in illness, poverty and hardship. فَأَذَاقَ اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ. Starvation and fear. These two main things in your life. You need food and you need security. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this away, He gives. He's al-mun'im. He's the one who is the Rahman and Rahim. But the people disobey. As Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu is saying, that ما نزل عذاب إلا بذنب وما رفع إلا بتوبة. There is no punishment fall down on the people unless they commit something haram. And it's not going to be removed until they repent and come back to Allah. So this is the time for the people and for every one of us to check himself and herself. What I'm doing wrong, how I can make a change. Not only by putting a mask in your mouth, you're trying to protect basically your body, your life. But do we try to put a mask on our worship that we stay away from the bid'ah and the shirk? No, you're concerned about corona will come. So put something in your mouth. What about your heart? What about your limbs that live in haram, day and night? What about your so-called worship in bid'ah? We're not paying attention to it. It became most of us, their focus, how I look, what I eat, my health, my strength, this it. Remember that you are a heart besides a body. Remember that you are supposed to be a Muslim besides being a human being. And this comes first. So we need to put the horse before the cart. Otherwise, the cart is not going to go anywhere. And the horse is the iman and the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The tawbah. To be on the sirat al-mustaqim. But all this temporary stuff is nothing, but in the end, those who put a mask and those who did not put a mask, they're going to die. And if it's not by corona, it will be something else. You can even die while you're sleeping in your nice, comfortable bed. We have to understand that we're surrounding with many things, but out of Allah's mercy, that He did not expose it to us. Look to the shayateen, the jinn. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek refuge against illness and sickness and from the jinn. Do you think the germ of corona is more dangerous than a shaitan? Do you know how serious is shaitan? We are here in a battlefield. And if corona is over, the shaitan is not over. He's going to be fighting and tricking you until you die. He's going to try to get you to hellfire because he doesn't want to go by himself. What is our attitude as Muslims in time of hardship and difficulty? If it's a flood, if it's earthquake, if it's a disaster, anything that happens to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And why? Because some people ask him why. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر. Mischief been on the earth and in the land and on the sea. It been there already. Why? بما كسبت أيدي الناس. That because what your hand had achieved. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا. So Allah can make them taste some of what the wrongdoing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring illness and bring about these disasters and all this hardship is because what we did. Name something haram is not been done by Muslims or non-Muslims. And nothing can be worse than shirk. Nothing can be worse than shirk. Calling in other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other than this, all the kabair, name it, it's been done by Muslims or non-Muslims. Public or in private, or at least they allow it. They license it. A man had married a man, a woman married a woman, and gambling and usury, and you can name it. By Muslims and non-Muslims. So what's happening is not because, no, this virus that you could not even see with your own eyes is one of the soldiers of Allah. You don't know how many soldiers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows the soldiers of Allah except Allah. This is only one single soldier. Can you imagine if he come this with all his army? When the people came to destroy the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about this story. وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ. They came with elephants. Allah sends them birds. تَرْمِيهِمْ بِحِجَارَةٍ مِنْ سِجِيلٍ. How much a bird can carry in his legs? It's not too much. Small like this. But always remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is behind the stone, the water, the virus, everything. And all the things as musakharat. Subjected by the order of Allah. Whenever Allah sends it towards any place, it will. Doesn't matter. You have a mask or not, it's going to come to you. I was so surprised to see yesterday on the internet this lady doctor that passed away while she was treating one of her patients from corona. So the doctor died and the patient was still there. Subhanallah. We have to reflect, my brother. This is time for reflection. This is time for to return back to Allah. This is time that we start to see what did we prepare for the day of judgment. And the time to reflect what kind of a change is going to happen after they open the masjid and after the stage is over and everything, you don't have to put a mask anymore in your face. What's going to be? What's going to happen? We're going to go back to what we used to do? Are we going to stop that usury? Are our wives going to stop walking like half naked, imitating the non-believers? What's going on? We have to take this time, today, yesterday, tomorrow, and you're going to have more time off, okay? That you need to use it to reflect, not to be sitting watching TV in the house. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, about our job in that time, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And he said, تَضَرَّعُوا وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ in Surah Al-An'am. That when the calamity had fallen them, they turned to Allah in dua and in tawheed and asked Allah and begged Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, they turn away. Because their heart been hardened. It's time for reflection, my brothers, for me and for you and for all the Muslims and for the non-Muslims. Because the calamity is not going to end by Corona over. No, it's going to be another calamity. And it's going, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. From the moment you come from your mother womb, that hardship is going to be facing you. Until the moment that you die. And when you die, that's not the end of it. Allah knows best what's going to be in the grave. So you are living through hardship. This is your, what you call being a child, or being teenagers, or being a man, or old man. Everybody, you're going to go from a trial to trial. The matter is nothing but a break between each trial. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. This is five subjects you'll be tested in. Fear, hunger and starvation. Your beloved one to be passing away, dying. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَبَشِّرْ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give glad tidings to the patients. One, may Allah make us among them. Ameen. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. Without Corona and before Corona and after Corona, we are living in time of fitna, time of temptation, time of shaking your heart, shaking your iman. You see the fitna? Not only in the street, is this a fitna even in your house? This 5-6 feet TV screen sitting in your living room, you or your wife, or you and your wife, or you and your wife and your children spending most of the time with them. The fitna even in our houses. We have to turn to Allah to strengthen us, because لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There is no power or might except by Allah. And if you think you can make it in your own, you deceive yourself. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's the Prophet, and he used to make the dua, اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. It's not an easy job to be a Muslim and to remain a Muslim. It's a struggle. It is a struggle, my brothers. And you have to understand this. It is a struggle. day and night to be Muslim, to be on the Sirat, to be doing the right thing. Not washy-washy or however they say. To stay Muslim and to stay truly Abdullah and Amatullah is not an easy job. So you need the help of Allah. You need to call in Allah. And this is time of fitna and temptation and trials. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us, al-ibadatu fil harji ka hijratun ilayh. This is a good news and we should take advantage of it. Ibadah, worshiping Allah, being a Muslim and true Abdullah during the time of temptation is like somebody who will make a migration to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's no way you can make hijrah today to the Prophet. But it will continue. How? By trying to remain a true Muslim, especially in this time that we live in. And it's going to get worse. It's going to be more temptation. Before I close my talk with you today, I want to remind you about something very important. Your children are home now. They are not going to school. They're going to school, but they are home. I want you to do two things. And I'm saying, do it not to do it for me. I want you to do two things to benefit yourself, inshallah. Number one, take advantage of this, that you strengthen your relationship with your family. Because before and after, soon, or sooner or later, Allah knows best, because there is some people who make news a time when you can go out now, when you could not. And Allah knows best what they're doing. Some of them, they're going to tell you 2 weeks, and some of them maybe giving it 2 months. And in some countries, or maybe even at least one country, they did not have anything, nothing. Okay? You go, you come, you gather, you don't gather, they are not even worried about what's going on. But you've been given another opportunity. Because usually every day you leave in by 6, 7 o'clock. You come back at 6, 7 o'clock at night. And barely tired to eat or all these things. You don't have too much time to spend with your children. So now, you are not working or you are not going to work. And your children, they are not in the school, but they are in the school. But you still face to face to each other every day. For at least a week or 2 weeks or whatever, all right? So try to strengthen your relationship with your family and get more closer to your children and to get to talk with each other and remind them about Islam. It's very important that we strengthen our relationship with our families, wives and children. The second thing that all of us have to do our best to learn more about our deen. You got the time now. You got the time. And please keep eye on your children. Because before you don't have too much time to be watching what they're doing or what they're saying, what they go. So now you have the time. Your children is a man, is a trust in your hand. Your children are the future of Islam in America or wherever they want to be. So do not neglect your amana, the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about it in the day of judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve the Muslims and everybody from this calamity and this hardship that fall in everybody. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it safe and secure for everybody. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring the Muslims back to their deen and to strengthen their iman. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استموا واعتدلوا. Straighten the line. Straighten the line is part of the prayer. استووا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل؟ ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
لإلاف قريش إلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف، فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.